Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to briefly speak in support of this motion. I have spoken on a few similar motions and moved ones myself in this place as well in recent times. And of course, I've introduced a bill to impose a positive duty on employers to prevent sexual harassment and discrimination. The Greens always have and always will condemn all forms of gendered violence, discrimination and harassment. And we stand by the calls, in particular of this motion, for an end to gendered violence in all workplaces, especially this one. I want to take this moment to commend all those who marched in the March for Justice rally in March this year, who stood against sexual harassment and assault, who stood together regardless of political affiliation or walk in life. And they stood against that harassment, not just in politics, but of course in all areas of our lives. I am, and so many others are too, Mr. President, absolutely sick and tired of having to have this fight. How many more will be hurt and have that hurt publicly picked apart before we change? Our collective anger runs deep, not just present in our lives now, but back through generations. Through the halls of this place and through other unsafe workplaces, back through our homes and our community spaces. We are done being silent with this issue. We are sick of it getting swept under the rug. We have had report after report outlining in excruciating detail the harassment and abuse that women are being subjected to and the lack of meaningful action that continues to stoke our collective rage. So in particular, I wish to highlight point 5 of this motion, calling for a review of the way that sexual harassment crimes are reported, investigated and prosecuted in our nation. This is of utmost importance. We know that so many sexual assaults are actually never reported and fewer still even prosecuted. We have heard time and time again how hard it is to get justice following a sexual assault. Well, it's well past time we fixed our laws to ensure justice and compassion for survivors. I note as well the call for the implementation of all the recommendations, both from the Equal Opportunity Commission's review of harassment in the South Australian parliamentary workplace and from the Australian Human Rights Commission's Respect at Work report of the National Inquiry into Sexual Harassment in Australian Workplaces. I think we've had a few such calls already in this place and certainly in other parliaments, but given the delays in even getting together a meeting of the committee that we have entrusted in this workplace with implementing those recommendations and reporting on our workplace, it seems clear to me that those commitments are not necessarily ones that will be heeded without reminders such as yet again this motion. Indeed, it's time for all in this parliament and for the Marshall government to get on with it. Certainly, I'd note that there's several of us here in this council who will keep reminding all leaders of all parties in this parliament of their obligations, of their promises and of their duty to ensure that we actually have eradicated gendered violence in our community and in our workplaces. The Greens will keep reminding them and committing this parliament to ending harassment and discrimination in this and every workplace, because these issues are not going away until we take serious action. And by the way, the Greens aren't going away anytime soon, so we'll be here to remind you until we get this job done. Mm-hmm.